Hello, my name is Jeff Jackson, and I'm an extension educator for the University of Minnesota. The Natural Resources Research Institute in Duluth, Minnesota, also known as NRI, has been breeding hybrid poplar trees for improved growth and disease resistance for over 25 years. Well, today we'll be talking about the commonly asked question, are these hybrid poplars invasive? You are looking at one of NRI's yield block plantings in northern Minnesota. These trees were planted in 2007 at an 8 by 8 foot spacing. I'd like you to spend a moment looking at the ground in this site with me. Unlike a natural forest, where the ground would be covered with seedlings from the mature trees, you'll notice that there are no tree seedlings on the ground in this 14-year-old site. You will also see there are no tree seedlings in the adjacent road ditch and open fields. Let's talk about why this is important. Hybrid poplars are not an invasive species risk for several reasons. The first is that the breeding process reduces the ability of the seed to successfully germinate. If seeds would happen to germinate, the seedlings will be easily outcompeted by natural vegetation. This is because hybrid poplars need intensive weed management to survive. Without intensive weed management, any germinating seeds will be suppressed by native grasses, shrubs, and trees. The NRI Hybrid Poplar Program has established over 45 field sites, like this one, throughout Minnesota and the Midwestern and Northeastern United States, and has never witnessed escaped seedlings surviving. It should also be noted that hybrid poplars have been planted across the United States landscape as windbreaks and landscape trees for over 100 years with no documented invasive species concerns. Thank you for watching this video. Our next video will explore how hybrid poplars are bred and answer the question, are NRI hybrid poplars genetically modified?